Hi everyone. I really do it first or second time and I don't understand if somebody hear me. But I'm really excited that you are here with me today. Let's just wait sometimes, so maybe more people will come. And before we will start, you can send me some questions, so we will see when we will see our beautiful life. Hi guys, Kalimera, good morning. Here we are near the Venetian castle, waiting for the people to come. It is Greece, it's an island of Crete, and we are in the city of Refimno. Welcome guys. We're in Greece. It's sunny, it's warm. We had about 3 days, 4 days raining, but now it's okay. Hi everyone, nice to see you. Hey, welcome to our beautiful town. Let me show you our beautiful town. Hi guys. Hi everyone. Hi. So we will slowly start. And I again welcome you in our Venetian castle of Fortezza. It's our point from where we will start our excursion. Hi, in Paris it's locked down. I'm so sorry to hear about that. In Greece we have only some regions which is closed, but Refimno is clear, so we are lucky. Today is very sunny weather. Okay, so we will slowly start, and I just want you to see these walls. This castle of Fortezza was built in the middle of 16th century by Venetians. Actually, we will today walk in the Venetian town of Refimno. Hi guys, hi. And so you will be jealous now, but I am touching the walls of 16th century castle. We should have like 2 hours to go inside. We will not go inside, just I wanted to watch it one more time, and we will go for our walk. It's very famous sightseeing in our town, and a lot of Greek people still coming here to see it. It's very beautiful, but it was built a little bit wrong, because when it was built, we will walk and I will show you that, when it was built, the people, the Venetian, could not think how many people can go inside of this castle. And when the Ottoman Empire came in the middle of the 16th century, they of course take this city, the city of Refimno, very fast. So beautiful. Yes guys, I see some guys who worked with me all of these years in Refimno, and I miss you so much. Like, it's crazy. I wanted to show you the beauty of this town. In every country you are, just know that we are missing you so much, and we are waiting for you next year. So let's just see again the beauty of the old town of Refimno, in which we're going now. And My road I choose today is a little bit not normal. No, this is not the road I usually do for a tourist. Let me introduce also myself, what I'm doing, and how I meet locally with whom I now did do this road. So, hi everyone who just came. My name is Daria. I'm a Russian student in Greece, and I'm living in Greece on the island of Crete about 6 years. I also study here history and archaeology, so probably the history stuff I talk about, I know what I'm talking about because I read a lot, and I spend a lot of my time in libraries studying things, and I'm working as a tourist guide around 6 years. So this year I could not actually work as a tour guide because we know why, because of the COVID. So I was so lucky to find the site of locally who helped me, and I hope I helped them also to bring a piece of Greece in your house. This is, again, you can see this, our beautiful town of Refimno, and today we will have a walk inside of this town. It's a third town on island of Crete, if we will see it in the people who lived in this town. It's 30,000. The first one is Heraklion. It is international airport inside also. After it is Hania, and look at the street. And after it is our Refimno. So the thing is with Crete, and generally with Refimno and with Crete, yes, it is Greece, but it has so many other countries who were here. And the Refimno, for example, was built, this town we saw now, was built in the middle of 16th century, maybe even before, by Venetians, by Italian. So when we will walk here right now, or when you will come again here next year, you will see, you will feel yourself like in Italy, because it was built by Italian guys. It was 1538 when it was built, after Barbarossa, the famous pirate, was destroyed all the city, and after the people second time built it in 1571, after the great fight with the Ottoman Empire in the city of Nafplio, it is in Greece, where the Ottoman Empire was fighting with all of the Europe, and the Europe stopped them. So after that, the Ottoman Empire destroyed all the Crete, all the cities, and here we are, have this city from the 16th century. Ah, the street, yeah, I like that you love it. I really love my town. So all these houses we saw, imagine that it's Venetian houses. Yes, modern people still live here. And to buy one house like that, or like that, or something like that, it costs about 300,000 euro, or 4 or 5, anyway. If you want to come, if you want to live here, if you are rich, you can do that. We will go now to the center of the Venetian town. Refimno has two parts. It has a modern city where is nothing interesting like any other Greek city, and it has an old town. Guys, if you were in Refimno, tell me, did you like our old town or not? And maybe the guys who were in Refimno, just tell me which part of the city you want to go. Today is everything for you, so I will go to the particular part. I will try, at least. Yeah, so inside of the old city of Refimno, which was built, as I said, in the middle of 16th century, it's about 600 streets, and if you go with one street, you cannot go back with another. It's a system which was invented by Venetians, and that system is called anti-pirate system. I'm not speaking now about pirates, now modern pirates. I'm talking about the kind of pirates like Jack Sparrow, who came here a lot, and the people, so they need the time to hide his family, to hide his money, hide himself, and to protect their city, they build a system inside of the city. Pirate who came, for example, in the evening, was almost always drunk. He was in the street, doesn't know where to go, and by this time, which pirate exploring this 600 streets, the people had opportunity to escape in some village. This is typical example of the houses. 300 euros and the house has two bedrooms. Yeah, it probably had two bedrooms. It has a bathroom. It has a terrazza, so you can see all the town of Refimno. And it probably had a small garden, something like that. Or maybe something like that. The thing is, even if you buy a house by 300, you should have other 300 euros to just maintain the beautiful of the house. Because, for example, let's see this house. This house is original. It's the Venetian, or this one. This one is better. If you, for example, want to paint it in a green color, you cannot do that because the color from the beginning was like that, and you should keep it. You should keep this color. If the door will be broken, you should replace this door with exactly same door as it was. In a lot of the houses we have now restaurants, as you can see, but we still have something Venetians as well. So you should be very rich, unfortunately, to have these houses. People who lived here on Crete, it's an old town of Refimno, and it's no signal, of course. No, we'll go out of set. The people who lived here, excuse me, Greeks, I mean, if you had heard that they are poor, don't believe in that, because maybe other part of Greece is poor, but the Greeks, the Cretan, are never poor. I mean, look at that. Can you say that the people who have this place are poor? No, because they are not. They have a Venetian houses, they cannot be poor. Most of the people who have these houses, they are they have some land, they have ships, they made olive oil, and usually they have a hotel or some restaurant, and it's a family business, so it's very nice here to live. So they don't have such a crisis, for example, which had other Greece. We didn't have that crisis. All the people who live here, if you went, for example, at evening somewhere, all the bars, all the restaurants will be full. Because, again, as I said, people have money. And they know how to have fun with this money. That's what I like. We'll go now to the very beautiful place, and I will tell you the history of this place. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate. Oh, we have now Greek school. Do not hesitate to send me your question if you have any. So this is the main square one of the main square in Refidmo. You can see a Greek school, it's a disaster, it's a catastrophe. I hope we will have time and we will not be with him inside of the city, because other way we will not hear a thing. It is, by the way, the old German school, old German something like government in the time of the Second World War. But this square is called Square of Mikrasiaton because of the, it was called in honor of the last Greek-Turkish war, which was in 1921. This is the art school. You can see the graffiti of that. And here's the place where usually people asking, are we sure, are we Greek? Are we in Greece? Because it's a mosque. And Greece, until this year, there was no mosque. Because Greeks had not a very good relationship with the Turkey, unfortunately, and with the Ottoman Empire. We just now speak about it with a historical side point of view. First, this building was a building of a monastery, of Dominican monastery. It was two monasteries here. Dominican monastery of, and it was Church of Saint Nicholas. Or of Saint Maria. After the Ottomans came, they built Medrese, this building, where the guys, where the boys and girls started studying Quran, the book, very important to the Muslims, and they built these temples, and they built a minaret. This is totally new. The Greek government spent a lot of money to construct it, and this is one of two minarets we have in Refidmo. Now it's not working, it's working as a conservatory, play music over there, and because of this it's very good acoustic. We'll go watch one beautiful arch and then we will go back in the old town. I'm sorry for the noises, but it's a winter time, and in winter time the government of Greece doing what? Destroy the city to build it up again, of course, after some years. Greeks are naturally very slow. I mean it, they are super slow. If they call you for coffee, it means not now, it means 1 week, 2 weeks, 1 month. So the best phrase you can, the most phrase you can hear if you are in Greece, siga 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 siga, it's slowly. don't run. And another phrase you can hear it's very often, it's halara. If somebody say to you halara, it means keep it slow, relax. It's like a motto. So this is one of my favorite place in town. I will explain why. As I said before, the town of Refidmo in Greek, it was built by Venetians in the middle of 15th, 16th century. Venetians were built houses like a pro. I mean, these stones, it was built by Venetians. After Venetians left the island in 1645, Ottoman Empire came. Ottoman Empire, if somebody were in Constantinople, in modern Istanbul, it's very beautiful, and the Ottomans knew how to build houses. But in Refidmo, we remember that Refidmo, it was not the central part of the Ottoman Empire. It was far away from the capital, and the guys here were building like that. This arch is a unique phenomenon, I think, in Greece, on Crete, because it's contained and Venetian part and Ottoman part. You can see. Okay, this is a quiz. Who is he? What kind of animal is it? What do you think? I will tell you in a minute, but I just want to hear your answers. Anyway, nobody speak with me. Anyway, this is the lion. Lion was the symbol of the Venetian Empire, of the Venetian. So everywhere in Refuma we will see lions. The thing is that they are looks like a ships. Well, at Crete, as I said, it's a lot of shipmen, and they love ships. They love goats. They never saw a lion even once. So they describe it. They design it like little ship, but it's a lion. And this symbol is the symbol of the Ottoman Empire. It's very important to them. Usually, they put it on in the cities to show that they take this city, that it's its own, their own. And usually, when they leave the city, they take it with them. So we here see mosque, minaret. This is the our earth. And this is the symbol of the Ottoman Empire and of the religion. It's a very rare symbol, you cannot see it usually when you're walking in the Greek cities. But if you're, for example, in Turkey, you see it. And this grape was symbol of the monastery because it was, I think, words of the Jesus. He said something about grape. And the monastery, whatever, like that. So we will go again inside the old town, again the, in the square of Mikrosiaton, and we will continue our walk in the Venetian street. This one, it was before, you see this one? This one, it was before a fabrica, I don't know how it calls in English, a place anyway, where they keep olive oil. And now it's an art school. And over there, it was a small Jewish community before Second World War, unfortunately. And after, it was the place where immigrants from Anatolia, from Turkey, modern Turkey, came, were live when they came in Greece after the Greek-Turks war in 1921. Basically, that's why this square is called like that. The people, we don't have enough, a lot of people on the streets because it's now 1-2 o'clock. And we have a siesta, guys. What did you think? We have a siesta. Their people are having rest. Nobody work and siesta. They sleep. They drink coffee, stuff like that. Okay, I told you that it's a 600 street and I don't, and sometimes even me, which who lives here 6 years, losing his, she's rope. This is one of the most nice bar here. And if you will come one day, I hope we will go all together to drink raki. Raki is Greek vodka. Okay, we drink that stuff. Greek vodka from grapes. This one, wooden kiosk, it's from Ottomans. It's a Venetian building. But it's from Ottomans, because Ottomans, as I said, in Refuma, they didn't build something much. So they just transformed already existing building. For example, this kiosk, this blue-gray one, it's Ottomans, which was built on the Venetian house. And this is one of the most rich region in town. It was houses of elite. It's now ethnological museum is here, folklore museum, and This is the hotel, one of the nicest hotel in Reifenau. We'll try to skip inside to see things inside. Just look at that. It's so beautiful, I think. I hope you like it. It's a hotel, and I really like this one. The guys, if we have some Russian, look here in this building was lived our general, and it was a lot of Russians generally on Crete when they try to help Cretan guys to get rid from the Ottomans. I now saw a question. So many Venetians. Yeah, a lot of Venetians were here. And now I saw a question also about population. The population of Reifenau, it's 30,000. The population of Crete, generally, of the island, it's 650,000. And the population of Greece, if I didn't make a mistake, it's 16 million, I guess. It's my friend, which was on the bicycle. He told me he will watch my life, but now he riding a bicycle. This is the old hammam. You can see, I cannot go inside, unfortunately. But I just want you to take a look how it goes with the modern architecture. It's two modern building, and between of them, it's the Venetian hammam. It's very beautiful. It's now everywhere. I feel food because it's time to eat. And if we will speak about food, it's a really nice Greek cuisine here. I mean, they don't eat a lot of meat. Ah, they make a leather things. If you're looking for souvenirs, they don't eat. Cretan don't eat a lot of meat, and Greeks doesn't love it as much as you can think. They eat mostly vegetables. It's again from the history side. Because the people who lived here before the tourism, before the 70s, in the 20th century, they were poor. They were working on their land, making cheese, making olive oil, making wine. It's not so much money. So they just doesn't have anything to buy meat. It can, the only rich people did that. Hi guys, who just came. It's a lot of church also in the town. And now I really want to go to the sea, where I will think we'll slowly finish our tour. Nostalgic, guys, yes. It's a lot of my co-workers here with me in this online tour, and I really hope you enjoy it. I will try to show you all the streets. Look at these doors. I mean, it's adorable. When I live here, is my experience, and when I walk here like that, I was always thinking, I live now in a modern boring building, it's nothing to talk about, but I always thinking what people who live in the such of the building think, how, like this for example, how he wake up, drink his coffee, and understand that he lives in a building of 16th century. I always said like that. I think they're living nice. Some, of course, of the building are abandoned. For example, like that. All co-workers here. Yes, guys. Hey, year of 20... What it was? What year it was? 2014. Girls. Look. This is the Venetian thing. Окей, girls, we must be. Мы должны собраться один день, господи, в Грецию и попить кофе. Sorry for my Russian. But I think mostly, most of the people who watch me now, they're Russian. This guy, this thing I told you about, this is the Offerman kiosk. They usually use it to create more space in the town. Давайте повторим трип. С меня раки. У меня 5 литров дома стоит. Не питых. Yeah, what I was talking about. Okay, guys, where we go? Left? Left. Yep, we'll go left. And we'll see this beautiful building. Raki, it's traditional drink of Cretans. In Greece, they usually drink tsipouro. Where's the sea? Regina, I can tell you that we are going now to the sea. That's my goal. I will pretend that I'm not lost in my own city, which I lived 6 years as a guide with 6 years experience. I will just say to you that I'm going to the sea. Frappe. Ah, frappe is very nice thing. Frappe, somebody doesn't know that, if somebody will watch us after. Frappe, it's a Nescafe, you can make it home. It's a Nescafe. With the cold water, with ice, and oh, look at that. Somebody is maybe hungry? This is one of the oldest bakeries you can remember. Frappe, yes, frappe is the Nescafe with the cold water, with the ice. You just mixed it with blender. And you have the most amazing coffee you can ever have. Food and most tasty food I ever try in Crete, it's this kind of pies. Pies with the spinach, with the cheese, with the apples, with everything. I mean, it's total magic. Ambrosia is on the sea. Ambrosia and Kostas this year having rest. Yes, Tamara said hi, by the way. Okay, now I just must confess to you that the people here are not that in modern technology, and they for sure doesn't understand what the thing I doing. Like, I walking on the street very often, and they know me because I, for example, go to the same bakery, taking coffee from the same place all the time, and now they cannot understand why I'm doing the thing like that. I mean, we have an internet on Crete. When we have it, I don't remember. Tragic. If somebody remember it, Regina. And why then hope goat? Yes, goat. All my goats in my village. All my goats. I will make a cheese pie after with my goats. Drink some raki. That's the fantasy how we live here. Sometimes people who came here in summer, they're like, "What are you doing here in winter time?" I mean, live, eat, take rest. Ah, you see our fortezza. We make a circle. Make a circle. And here we can see a sea, an Aegean Sea. This is our parliament, Peripheria. It's called Peripheria Critis, Peripheria Kionotita. If we'll try to describe what is that, it's administration of the town, where is all the boring questions discussed by boring people. I don't like politics, as you can understand. Winter siesta. Where is the Bighetti Bay? Bighetti Bay is closed as well. Family of Bighetti opened a villa next to this hotel, if you would like to know. They're doing fine without everybody. Hi guys who just came. We are in the city of Refimno, and we are going to see my favorite view. Sometimes when I boring from frappe and pies in the cafe and the taverns, hi Fortezza once again, I'm going to sit here. That's why I love Refimno, because you can sit everywhere, and everywhere will be amazing view. 2020 killed tourism, yes. But as we said, we have our goats. We don't need tourism. So guys, the best view is the sea. Okay, I will do it slowly for you. Here's Fortezza we were. And here is our sea, Aegean Sea. This is the other part of the town of Refimno. It's a modern part. We will not go there because it's a lot. Over there it's our army. Over there it's modern cities, our university which I study. But of course it's about the sea. Can you imagine that people still make swim in this time of year? Over there, where's the trees, they make a bath, they swimming. Look how clear is that. I will not speak for some minutes, I will just leave you to unfortunately, with the camera, I cannot say how great is this salt smell of the sea. The people are busy with their own plants and living this life normally. I will just want to say before I will finish my tour that the COVID and the 2020 were catastrophic, of course, but not that catastrophic as we all waited. It was not working in Refimno about 40% of the hotels, but still we had the tourism, and still we have people, and most important, we have a mood for the next year to do it even more exciting, to do more excited trips. I spoke with the guys who work in the tourism, and everybody said that we missed so much our people. I mean, could you imagine that after summer season we miss people? Yeah, we do. We really want you to come to see this beauty by your own eyes, and I really like you to be with me on face to face on these walks, because I tried my best to describe and to show you Refimno, But of course, when you go by this street, you can touch every building, you can smell the coffee, and you can smell the sea, you can hear the sea. It's another story. So I would like, I'm happy. Of course I'm happy to live in Refn. No, come on, it says everything. It's really nice. And it's not boring at all. Don't believe it, that people. It's really great. Very, even after 6 years, I still sometimes walking and found some places I never were. Some hiding secrets, some treasure. This year I opened a bicycle for me, so I go out of the town and I also drive a car. Προσοχή, I don't remember how to say English. Be careful, because I'm driving as well. I hope next season will be better as well, guys. And I hope someday I will see you at Crete again. These streets together. Okay guys, this is the final call for some question, if you have any. Я стык цивилизации прошел успешно. One last call for the last question, if you have something to ask about Refno and Greece generally. And my iPhone is going to be dead after that. After that tour. Okay, I can take you with me. Go, come. Take a boat and come. Everyone who wants to come here, just take one, rent one boat and came here. We have place to live. So okay guys, I say hello to everyone. I will take my camera with me because I still need it. And I hope to see you really really soon. I hope all the bad things will go away and we keep love to Refn and the dreams in our hearts. I want to thank you so much to be with me with this road. I want to thank you locally for this opportunity to make this trip for you, and I hope we will speak. Just if you want, and you have possibility, comment how do you like this trip, and να έχετε καλή μέρα. Have a good day. Για μας όχι να τσιριστούμε.